So I'm happy to answer any questions you may have, and I'll just let you fire away.
So if you get the nomination, is Governor Perdue going to be at the top of your vice presidential candidates list?
He very well may be. I think he's having too much fun to think about it, but let me tell you, America would be well-served to have somebody of his integrity and competence and leadership skills, and it's a great idea.
Why did you make Middle Georgia Today an important stop on the campaign?
Well, this is a great event. In fact, Governor Perdue was the one who originally started the fish fry years ago. I think they called it Sonny's Fish Fry, and it's developed into a growing and big event to bring people together from all over the district. And there were people from throughout Georgia who came today to be a part of what was a terrific gathering of Republicans who want to get America going again. And fortunately, to show you how smart the people are here in Perry, Georgia, they held the event indoors. And that just shows you that they're the kind of people that we could trust and put our faith and hope in.
Can I ask your opinion of Thursday night's debate, how you felt it went?
You know, I thought it was a great debate because it gave America an opportunity to see 17 different people in two different formats who are all seeking the office of presidency. I felt like that it was focused on the issues, and obviously, every one of us on that stage would like more time. Every one of us on the stage would like to pick the questions that are presented to us, but it's not the way it works. So you take the pitches that are thrown to you across the plate, and you try to hit them and connect with them. And I felt like that we all had a great opportunity to present our case to the American people. The ultimate winner in that debate was not one of the 17 of us. It was the American public. The Democrats might ought to try something like that occasionally, put their ideas and their candidates out. Let them handle tough questions and see if they have something to say to America that might get our country going again.
How do you respond to last night's decision? Mr. Erickson took out candidate Donald Trump out from the debate today. How do you respond to that?
Well, I was at the Red State event earlier today, and obviously there was a lot of conversation about that. Look, it's his event. He can do whatever he wants to. I've been very clear that because of my long relationship with Megyn Kelly as a colleague at Fox News, I know her to be a person of impeccable integrity. She is the consummate pro. Anybody who's worked with her knows that there is nobody in the business who has a greater level of integrity in what she does and the manner in which she does it than Megyn Kelly. So I'm always disappointed if someone attacks somebody that I know, somebody I like, and somebody that I feel is a true professional. And she's all of those things. And to tell you, even though I've known Megan and worked with her in that building, where she is, by the way, beloved, every time I'm on her show as a candidate, I can assure you she cuts me no quarter. Mm-hmm. I mean, she comes after me and asks tough questions. And it's one of the reasons that I truly respect her, because she treats everyone the same. She asks hard-hitting questions, but she never plays a cheap gotcha game. She asks fair questions, questions that she has a right to ask, and questions, frankly, that a person running for president ought to have to answer. And she's put me through that drill, and I respect her for that.
One more question. Back to the Thursday night's debate, how do you think you did? Do you think you got all your messages across to the American people?
Well, I doubt I got all my messages across, because there were a lot of things I would love to have said, but I mean, I had, I think, a total time of about 6 minutes to say something in 2 hours, and believe me, I can talk a lot longer than that. But I thought that the questions I got were reasonable, responsible, and fair questions. I didn't think that anything was said to me that was a cheap shot, that was out of bounds. And I think, quite frankly, if you're running for president, you better be willing to step up, put your big boy pants on, and just be ready for anything, because you don't know what's coming. And I think that's one of the advantages that I have from having run for president before. You realize this ain't beanbag. And if you can't stand the side of your own blood, you best not get into the presidential sweepstakes.